Look, everybody, this battle between Battlefield 2042 and Call of Duty Vanguard is just beginning. Now, when Battlefield got revealed, the hype was through the roof. They did a lot of things right. I mean, there's a lot of things coming in the pipeline that people are excited for, and we didn't know anything about Call of Duty Vanguard. Now, we have Call of Duty Vanguard Champions Hill Alpha under our belt. You've actually got to play the game, and you can make some decisions. But we go back and forth with which one is doing things the best. Welcome, everybody. Welcome to the page. Jimmy, your Chaos here. And today, I think this could be a misstep from Battlefield. I really do. Now, there's always the argument whether a campaign is important or not to a game. It's obviously not something that is put in there for replayability factor for the most part. They want to keep you on the game. They want you in multiplayer. They want you in whatever live type service they can get you in, right? But the campaign, it's fun. Well, Battlefield was knocking it out of the park. They had these little movies coming out. They were connecting you with some of the characters right out of the gate with the reveal. And now it looks like Battlefield 2042 will not have a campaign at launch. It also won't have a battle royale, which we'll talk about in a minute. But it really just kind of baffles me. They said the campaign is not within the initial launch scope. Now, if you don't care about the campaign, this probably isn't that big a deal to you. But if you're one that likes to jump into the lore and really connect to a game, there's ways to connect to a game through campaign, and then it kind of transcends over to the other modes. And Battlefield looks gorgeous. Looks absolutely amazing. But now you're not going to be able to connect to it. They do say that it's such a rich environment and there's so many things going on that you will still be able to feel like a connection. Come on, we've been there before. That doesn't really work. Let's be honest here. That doesn't really work. I want you guys to think back to Black Ops 4. Remember our little cutscenes and stuff we got at the beginning in our player profiles and the specialist profile? It didn't matter. Nobody connected to it like you would a game that actually built out and fleshed out the story and the characters. So we go over to Call of Duty Vanguard, and you can have your opinion on multiplayer so far, what you think about going back to COD World War II, but I don't think anybody's going to deny the campaign looks amazing, looks phenomenal, may end up looking better than Modern Warfare 2019's campaign, which I didn't think was going to be possible anytime in the near future. So if we're talking about campaigns, Call of Duty checkmark. They're going to have one. It's probably going to be sensational. Hopefully it won't be 4 hours long. Hopefully it'll be like 8 to 12 or maybe even longer than that. Battlefield 2042, no campaign. Now, I know that's not a big deal to a lot, but I just don't, I don't know. They had 3 years to make the game, no campaign. And they are trying to connect us to some of these characters in their little movies and cinematics they're doing. I don't really understand it. Or maybe, I guess campaign may not be that profitable anymore. It's probably, obviously, it's not as profitable as multiplayer or Battle Royale. Speaking of that, there's no Battle Royale for Battlefield 2042 at launch either. Now, they say it's not in the initial launch scope, which leaves the window open to drop it later. Because let's be real, part of the roadmap for all these games now is what content can we deliver down the road to keep people interested. So Battlefield's not going to get a Battle Royale at launch, so Warzone doesn't have any competition there yet. That doesn't mean it's not going to come in the future. Let me know what you guys think about no campaign in Battlefield 2042, and I'll see you soon.